We're back.
Hello.
Sorry, we missed a week because Logan and Elaine were on their much anticipated honeymoon. The what do we call it? First part, the preamble or the intro was. You saw a few clips. Preamble.
Opening.
A few clips of them in Winter Park, Colorado. So we've decided instead of combine the 2 weeks, you know, because we missed last week, that we're just doing the last 7 days because the 2 weeks would have been too much.
Yeah.
So you want to explain who we are and what we do?
We are Brent and Amy Powell. We have Home Team Powell, which is a Keller Williams Olympic company.
We're something real estate. Like
that. Yeah.
Yeah.
We look at homes, we sell homes, we list homes, we walk around homes. We think about homes. We
talk about homes.
All those things.
Paint homes. I've been painting our ADU out there.
Anyway, we stay busy.
I got paint on my hands.
Yeah, he's got his paint pants on too.
Yeah.
Because he's going to paint after this.
Yeah, they've got this. The paint now, I used to be a professional painter like, you know, 50 years ago. And then it had to be at least 50 degrees for the paint to dry. But by golly, this paint dries down to about, as long as it's not freezing, 35, 40, just fine to paint.
Yeah, I remember you tenting houses.
Yeah.
To get, and then heat underneath the plastic to get
the
stupid.
Yeah, it was terrible.
Yeah.
So it's, and now it's in the mid 30s, so it's a little chilly out here.
Let's see, what do we have?
And it's probably gone up.
38.
38. Yeah, it's a heat wave.
Whoop. Got down to 7 in Colorado.
Yeah, ooh. Got down to 7 in Colorado.
And look, it's blue. There's blue. We haven't seen blue in a week.
Okay, so we're going to start in Port Angeles. We have had 5 homes close this last week. We start with the least expensive and then kind of go up from there. And then we start over again in Sequim, same strategy. So the first home in Port Angeles to close in this last 7 days, and usually this means it went under contract 4 to 6 weeks ago, is on Dolan. And this one sold at asking at
which is up the hill, kind of straight. Winnie, that's Winnie. Straight up the hill.
Yeah, Dolan.
Yep.
Thank you, honey.
Yeah, it has a water view.
329. 3 bedrooms, 1 bath, 1 half bath, 4 days on the market, built in 1964. 924 square feet at 0.18 of an acre, and they have salt water and mountain view.
Yeah, nice neighborhood. All right, the next house is on West 15th Street. Listed for 369, it sold for 330. 3 bedrooms, 2 baths, 43 days on the market, built in 06 with 1620 square feet on 0.16 of an acre with a territorial view. And I don't remember anything about this house, I think.
Okay.
Unless it was the smoker's house.
No, I don't think it was.
Okay.
Okay, the next one is on Madrona Street, Port Angeles. Listed for $375,000, sold for $365,000. 4 bedrooms, 2 baths, 11 days on the market. Built in 1991. With 1,664 square feet on 0.14 of an acre, and they have a mountain view.
Should we discuss like where Madrona Street is, neighborhood? Because people are wanting to know what the neighborhoods are like. Do
okay.
You know where that is?
No, I have no idea where that is.
It's over by
C Street Extension.
Yeah, C Street Extension.
Oh, that's right,
that
yeah.
area.
Yeah.
And Fairmont. Fairmont.
Fairmont, yeah.
Fairmont, yeah. Okay, so now you have it. The next one is on Cedar Park Drive. We've sold many houses up there. It's behind a restaurant that no longer is open, Stacy Bone. Really nice neighborhood. We ride our bikes up there all the time.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, moving on. It was a $489,000 house, and it sold for $440,000. 3 bedrooms, 2 baths, 11 days on the market, built in 1964, with 1430 square feet on 0.34 of an acre, in a territorial view.
Okay.
And the close to the trail.
Close to the Olympic Discovery Trail. The last one is on Howard Road, Sold at asking at $425,000, four bedrooms, two baths. Built in 1998, 1,746 square feet on 5.03 acres, and they have a saltwater view.
And 0 days on the market.
Yeah, it just flew off the market.
Yeah. Okay, starting in Sequim on 5th Street, North 5th. North 5th is loaded with manufactured homes that are on leased land. So it's close to everything. It can be attractive in that way for seniors, and it is a senior only. Listed for $179, it sold for $170. Two bedrooms, two baths, 18 days on the market, built in 1990 with 1,388 square feet and a neighborhood view.
Right. Okay, the next one is on Winterhawk, and you sold a home just down the street from this one. And this is originally priced for $369, sold for $375, so a little bit over. Three bedrooms, two baths, 13 days on the market. Built in 2001 with 1,188 square feet, 0.19 of an acre, and they have mountain view.
And that's one of the cases where you actually own the land in that mobile home park.
Yeah, it's manufactured.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. East First Street in Sequim, listed for $385, and that's what it sold for. Three bedrooms, two baths, 1 day on the market. People like that one. Built in 2013 with 1,200 square feet on 0.22 of an acre and a mountain view.
Okay. Drake Road. We like Drake Road. Originally priced for $400.
Do we?
I do. Well, I like the name, Drake. It's
no,
not
dry.
Drake, it's Drake, yeah, D-R-Y. Okay, originally priced for $489, sold for $470. Three bedrooms, two baths, one half bath, 19 days on the market, built in 1992 with 1,709 square feet, and just a little more than a third of an acre with a neighborhood view.
Cool. Speaking of Drake, in a week, Logan gets a puppy named Burke.
Speaking of Drake.
Well,
tomorrow.
Was that you getting tomorrow? Oh boy.
Whoop whoop.
So I won't be at church.
Yeah, so we'll have Berkey here
next week.
Nice.
All right, we'll introduce you to Burke. Another border poodle mix.
Winnie's
half
sister brother.
Half brother.
Yeah.
Brother.
Not step.
I know.
Half brother. Same mom. Okay, this one is on Rhododendron Drive. Where is Rhododendron Drive, honey?
Yeah, do you know?
I do too. Okay.
You can tell them.
No. I know. We don't drink really hardly at all. And not early in the morning if you were wondering.
Saturday morning.
Anyway.
I don't know that you know.
Okay, Rhododendron Drive is east of Port Sequim, kind of in a, what's that area called?
He didn't know. Diamond Point,
yeah. They've got their own airport. And well, it's kind of a little...
If you have a hang glider, you can land there.
Oh, it's a small airport. But, yeah, it's almost like a commune, but it's not. I think people just build a bunch of houses out there.
That's a view.
You know, you kind of almost expect to see the home of some divine person out there. But
divine?
Well, you know, communes, they got a guru or somebody. Okay, were you going to read the information on this one?
Okay, I thought you were just reading.
No,
it. I did. I thought I did Drake Road.
No, I did Drake Road. Sorry, we're a little rugged. We missed a week, so we kind of forget
out of sync.
Forget how to do this.
So on Rhododendron Drive, listed for $499. That's what it sold for. Miraculously, three bedrooms, two baths, 7 days on the market. Built in 1997. With 1,512 square feet, 0.76 of an acre on a territorial view. This one doesn't have the water view like some of them.
Yeah, a lot of them do there. So the next home is on Laura Lane, sold at asking at $550,000. Two bedrooms, one bath, 23 days on the market, built in 2020 with 879 square feet, 2.67 acres with a mountain view.
Nice. And moving right along, I think this is the second to last, isn't it? No, we got third to last. Cedar Street, listed at 559. It sold at 555. It's in the town part of Sequim, downtown. Three bedrooms, three baths, 3 days on the market. A lot of threes. Built in 1990 with 2037 square feet on a quarter of an acre and a mountain view.
Okay. Last page of Sequim Homes. Second to the last, Victoria View Street. And I'm guessing that...
Yeah. Must have...
Although it says it doesn't have a water view. Victoria View, maybe... Victoria is just 18 miles across the water, and we have the local ferry, the Coho, goes over there.
Canada.
In Canada, yeah, Kanata, where they make those mints, I guess. So, don't they have Canada mints or something we used to buy at the movie theater years ago? Okay, 664.
Those were peanuts, circus peanuts.
Okay, originally priced at $664,900, sold for $664,000.
Big numbers here, Brett.
$646,400. There we go. Two bedrooms, two baths, one half bath, 2 days on the market, built in 1974 with 1,865 square feet, nice sized home. 0.39 of an acre, and territorial view. So you've got the last one, honey.
Okay, bringing it home. Quail's Roost Road. This is a nice one. Listed for $999. It sold for $950. Three bedrooms, three and a half baths, 38 days on the market. Built in 1994 with 3,571 square feet on 2 acres, saltwater, and mountain view.
That wraps it up for today.
That does. And you were going to say something about the market?
Yeah, I try not to do too much research on the market because you get a lot of experts' opinions, and we found that there's a lot of people who claim to be the experts. They just don't know what they're talking about because they make these predictions down the road. Nah, didn't happen. Some people are predicting a big recovery, and some are predicting a huge crash. And
it's going to be one of those.
Yeah. And some people are predicting it will remain the same. So what my feeling is, and the article I read was from Forbes magazine, I guess. And they were saying that given all of the dynamics, that it's probably not likely to change in 2024. If you read some of the doomsayers, they're predicting a huge crash in 2024.
Which will bring the prices down.
Which could bring the prices down.
Yeah.
It looks like there's been a slight improvement in interest rates. So
yeah, there has been this.
No longer up in the eights. Now it's somewhere between 6% and 7%.
Yeah.
So that is encouraging. You have any input on the market?
No, but at the end of the year, here in the next week or two, I'm going to do a kind of an analysis of all of what's happened this year.
Yeah, we can give you an analysis on our market, and we understand that there are pockets of markets around the country that vary greatly. Although I thought it was interesting in this Forbes article that one of the suggestions was if you wanted to find a more reasonably priced house, and they didn't actually say move to Arkansas or Kentucky or Tennessee.
West Virginia,
but... you could sell if you're in a high-priced area like Washington State is, or Maryland, or some of the northern states, to move south.
Maryland?
I guess. Isn't Maryland high-priced? It's over by Washington, D.C.
Northern state?
Is Maryland a northern state?
Well,
yeah.
Mid-Atlantic.
Okay, we're going to get picky here. Okay. Some of the mid-Atlantic states. But anyway, we've got a friend that is currently wanting to move to...
Arkansas,
because dang, you can get a pretty nice home for like $300,000. So anyway, that's it. Thanks for tuning in. We appreciate you guys. We get to see some of you occasionally. And anyway, if you're in our neighborhood, we represent buyers and sellers, and we do a pretty good job of it. We've been doing this cumulatively between the two of us, 20 years or something?
I don't know.
So
yeah.
we do know a thing or two, and we'd love to help you in whatever you want to accomplish.
Find your right place, sell your right place.
Yeah. Have a great week. See you next week.